10 years ago, I released a movie film which brought great shame to Kazakhstan. Now I was instructed to return to Yankee Land to carry out secret mission.
I go to America!
Love him or hate him, Borat is back. The sequel to Sacha Baron Cohen's offbeat 2006 mockumentary will begin streaming tomorrow on Amazon Prime.
Very nice.
Yeah, I was going to say, Richard Southern joins us now with more. And we saw a crazy Borat promotional stunt here in Toronto today that maybe not everyone thinks was very nice.
Borat showed up in Toronto today, Janella, or at least a giant inflatable version of him did. This is what was in the waterfront, a Borat barge.
Wow.
That's not how you wear a mask properly, is it, Janella? My goodness. Borat, he really got the hairy legs going on, too. Anyways, this is, as you say, look at that. Everyone was taking selfies down at the waterfront today. The kayakers didn't know what to make of it. Anyways, that's to promote his new film. And, you know, this new film that comes out tomorrow could even influence the U.S. election, Janella, because it's been revealed that in this new Borat movie, he caught Rudolph Giuliani, Trump's personal attorney, in a compromising situation. Borat's supposed daughter in the film lures Giuliani into a hotel room, and a freeze frame from the movie shows Giuliani with his hand down his pants. Now, Giuliani denies any wrongdoing, but this could even come up in the debate tonight as possible, Janella. So Borat really making some political waves with this new film.
Yes, Giuliani claimed he was removing his microphone and was tucking his shirt back in his pants, and it was completely taken out of context. But yes, as Borat would say, wah, wah, wee, wah.
We promise we'll do no more Borat impressions.
No more Borat impressions, that's it. Okay. All right, nice. And you mentioned the final U.S. presidential debate tonight. We will have a full wrap of that on City News at 11. But Donald Trump might have a little egg on his face before he even takes the stage.
So this is really interesting. A Dutch computer researcher, he calls himself an ethical hacker. He says he logged in to Trump's Twitter account last Friday, and he did it simply by guessing the password. And you know what he says the password was, Janelle?
What?
Mega 2020 with an exclamation mark.
Like M-A-G-A, like Make America Great Again?
M-A-G-A 2020, oh. No spaces with an exclamation mark.
Not very creative.
No. Anyways, he didn't tweet from the account. He said he alerted the U.S. authorities who contacted him about it. There was no two-factor authentication used, which we all should use on these things. But anyways, Twitter says they know nothing about that. But could it be a very simple login there for the U.S. president?
At least it was an ethical hacker who didn't do anything with the password and alerted the authorities. That would have been interesting.
It could have got ugly.
I mean, who would have even known who was tweeting, the things that come
out
of that
account? Could have been dangerous, yeah.
Thanks so much, Richard. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.